This has been a particularly tough week and a half or so in America, largely because of the President of the United States targeting a sitting member of Congress, Congressman Elijah Cummings, who's also the chairman of Oversight Committee, the president unleashing racist rants targeting the congressman. And then, of course, so many people, including other Baltimoreans, who came to his aid. And now today, Elijah Cummings in Baltimore addressing all that has been experienced.
Yeah, common help. That's right. They can bring resources. Again, you need to read the Sun paper. I got to give it to them. They showed where Baltimore is not getting all the money that the president claims we're getting. And that a huge percentage, I mean, I think we got $8 billion over 2 years, and 3.5 of that go to our hospitals, 3.5. And then when you see the breakdown, and I beg you to go and read, okay, what we have done in this city. And while you're here, tour the city. You need to go. Almost anywhere you go, anywhere near here, including downtown, is my district. And so we work with our business people, and they work with us. Johns Hopkins, University of Maryland have been phenomenal. And so, again, I'm meeting people every day, young people who came up in difficult and challenging circumstances who are now doing great things. And I tell you, it feeds my soul. This is what feeds my soul. So I don't have time for... my mother used to say, you concentrate on the things that are most important to you. And these kinds of things are most important to me.
Sir, half the House Democrats have come out now in favor of impeachment. Is it time to proceed to an inquiry or a formal proceeding?
That's a very good question. You know, I've said, first of all, I'm very clued in to what is going on with regard to impeachment. And I agree with Nancy Pelosi. You got to keep in mind that I am one of the investigating, head up one of the investigating committees. So I think her course is the proper one. We are doing our research. We are trying to do our jobs. And there may very well come a time when a peace impeachment is appropriate. I've said many times that one of the lines for me would be when and if the administration disobeys court orders, because I think then we have no choice. So we'll see.
Do you think your committee's work ignited the president's criticism?
I'm sorry?
Did your committee's work, you think, ignited the president's criticism?
What do you mean? I don't understand.
The hearing with McLean?
I don't know. That's another great question. I do not know. But by the way, to that last your question, you know, a lot of people may question our decision. Remember, I haven't called for his impeachment. And I'm trying to be fair to him, too. I want to be fair. And that's why we need to do our research. And, you know, and that's the way it is. One of the things that I want is to preserve our democracy. I worry that the democracy that we have will not be if we do not do something. And we'll do it. And we'll do what we have to do to address these issues. But I'm not doing this for myself. At 68 years old and a black man in America, I realize my life is short. I'm doing it for generations yet unborn. And that's what's so important. We want to send people into the future. I often say, our children are the living messengers we send to a future we will never see. And I want to send them strong, bright, healthy, bold, and full of hope. And so I think, you know, when I hear criticism by anybody about my city, I think the thing that bothers me most is that we have a situation where there are folks who are stepping on the foot on the hope of our children. If I had the, I don't know what I would have done if I had people in high places when I was a little boy telling me what I couldn't do. Instead, I had people telling me what I could do. And the other thing, somebody asked a question about what do I want to say to the community, to the Baltimore community. I want to thank you. I want to thank the Johns Hopkins of the world. I want to thank the Under Armour of the world. They give the programs like this on a weekly basis or a monthly basis. I want to thank the Weinberg Foundation, so many foundations, and all of those people who have helped us to make sure that our children grow up to be all that they can be. All right? That's it. All right. I hope I gave you enough that you can work with. All right.
All right, you see there, Congressman Elijah Cummings there of Maryland's 7th District there, responding to the week and a half that it has been particularly for him, starting with more than a week ago, was the President of the United States, you know, tweeting out criticism of Congressman Cummings, calling his district, I'm quoting now, the worst run and most dangerous anywhere in the United States. No human being would want to live there, insulting a host of people, not just the congressman, but then so many coming out in defense, from, you know, actress Jada Pinkett to our own Victor Blackwell, talking about how hurtful seeing those comments from a president of the United States about Congressman Cummings and how those comments impact individuals from Baltimore and beyond. The congressman coming out today at a grand opening of a play area in his district, and today being compelled to respond to how so much support has come his way. And of course, thanking those who have supported him. You know, Congressman Cummings had responded via tweet and otherwise about how he goes to his district every day and how his commitment remains strong to his district and, of course, to all Americans.